In the Drawing Properties flyout menu, there is now an option to customize the appearance of centermarks. There is the option to have extended lines and also the line width, the size of the marks, the size of the gaps, and the color can be changed. The set values can of course be saved with drawing templates. We've added a new CAD feature to the Part Studio called Rule Surface. A rule surface can be created from existing edges or multiple edges of a part, surface, or sketch region. In this example, I've chosen multiple existing edges to create a ruled surface. You have the option to choose from multiple surface types like normal, tangent, or create a surface which is aligned or angled from a selected direction. Specify the angle and length of the surface in relation to the selected edges and choose a corner type. Spun corner is the default. The other options are extended corners, which will extend the corners to create a straight edge, lofted corners will produce a slightly lofted corner, and no corners will remove all the corners. To generate a clearer and simpler instance list in an assembly, folders can now be created. When you create a folder, it is added to the end of the instance list and instances can be dragged and dropped into it. Alternatively, you can first select the instances and then pack the selection to a folder by clicking the folder icon or by selecting Add Selection to Folder in the context menu. All these instances can now be collectively hidden, suppressed, deleted, or unpacked again.
Thanks for watching. Click the logo to subscribe or see some of our other videos linked here.